Hello students, welcome back to my channel, The Ocean of Chemistry. I'm Thaddeus Baluka, your chemistry mentor. In our today's video, I'll be navigating the topic of air and combustion. My subtopic of interest today is oxygen. So watch until the end. I'll take you through all the areas, all the possible questions that the examiner can think. It is a journey through the mind of an examiner. So let's look at the questions that I've tabulated. So the diagram below represents the setup that can be used to prepare and collect oxygen gun in the laboratory. By the end of this particular analysis, you have scooped 27 marks. First of all, attempt the questions before you look at the answers. Here you have the setup, you have liquid K, and you have solid P. Both of those two reactants are reacting to produce oxygen gas. The gas is being collected over water. So let's try to analyze what are some of the questions that can be derived, that can be tested on preparation of oxygen gas. Part number one, give two possible identities of solid P and liquid K. In this kind of analysis, you need to remember that wherever you're preparing oxygen, there are two possible solids that can react with two possible liquids. What are they? So that is what we are looking at. So name two possible identities of solid P and liquid K. So the liquid K is here and solid P here. So we are saying there are two possibilities that can be liquid K reacting with a particular solid. So there are also two possible solids that can be used. That is what we're asking. What property of oxygen makes it possible to be collected as indicated in the diagram? The diagram, the gas is being collected over water. So what property of oxygen makes it possible to be collected over water? Number two, we have explain why it is important not to collect any gas for the first few seconds of the experiment. Oxygen can be prepared in the laboratory by heating potassium manganate 7, sodium nitrate, or potassium chlorate. You are required to draw a well-labeled diagram to show how oxygen can be prepared and collected. 9 marks. Write chemical equations for the reaction that take place in the above experiment. Then state two physical properties of oxygen gas. Give two commercial uses of oxygen gas. Describe a chemical test for oxygen gas and give a reason why it is not advisable to collect oxygen by either upward or downward delivery. Then you suggest a suitable method that can be used to collect dry oxygen gas. Now let us look at the questions. Let's now try to look at the expected response. Remember, before you go for the answers, pause the video. First of all, work on the questions. So these are the expectations. There are two solids that can be used when you're preparing oxygen. What are those two solids? The solid P can be sodium peroxide reacting with water. The solid can also be manganese 4 oxide, but now the liquid will be hydrogen peroxide. Get that one very clearly. If in a normal examination you are taught to give a possible identity of solid P and liquid K, you can say sodium peroxide and water, or manganese 4 oxide and hydrogen peroxide. The two pair of reagents must be correct for you to score. You assume a student picked manganese 4 oxide and water. Manganese 4 oxide is correct, and water is also a liquid. But the two reagents, water cannot react with manganese 4 oxide to produce oxygen gas. Therefore, those pair of reagents become wrong. So for such kind of a question, the two reagents must be correct for the student to get full credit. And that is why it is very, very important for students to be able to master the correct pair of reagents that can be used in any experimental setup. Remember, I've said, if either student has written sodium peroxide and water or manganese 4 oxide and hydrogen peroxide, what property of oxygen makes it possible to be collected as the diagram? And the diagram, the oxygen is being collected over water. It is because it is slightly soluble in water. It is slightly soluble in water. And that is why it's being collected over water. Not insoluble. It is slightly soluble in water. The only gas that is completely insoluble in water is hydrogen gas. Get that one right. Number two, the other question that we are looking at, why it is important, explain why it is important not to collect any gas for the first few seconds. This is because before when the experiment is starting, there are some gas that is already in the flask. Therefore, you allow the first few bubbles to escape so that you can collect a pure sample. So the first sample is impure and mainly contain the air initially in the flask before any gas was produced. That's why we don't collect the first few bubbles. Oxygen can be prepared in the lab by eating potassium manganate 7, sodium nitrate, or potassium chlorate. You are required to draw a well-labeled diagram to show how oxygen can be prepared and collected. So you need to put the reagent there. This is now showing you how it is very simple to simplify. This is what you call the octopus technique, trying to summarize the collection. The collection is simply the same. The only thing that you're going to vary, the experimental setup remains the same. The only thing that we're changing here is the reagent. So all these reagents, the potassium manganate 7, potassium chlorate, and sodium nitrate, for all of them, you need heating is necessary. There is a condition, heating is necessary. So you have the bath and burner, you have the potassium chlorate, sodium nitrate, or potassium manganate 7. When you heat all these reagents, you're going to get oxygen. And because oxygen is insoluble in water, it is collected over water. Simple like that. Very important. Then we continue and we look at right chemical equation. And you can be able to get that. Remember, for Form 1, you have not learned about the chemical equations. But for purposes of students who are already in Form 4, I've given you both the chemical and the word equation. For a Form 1 who is revising this, just focus on the word equation. So the first one is potassium manganate. That's the formula for potassium manganate 7. Once you heat, you get... Once you hit this one, you're going to get, we can be able to get this. So you need some heat here. Yeah? You need to heat. So you need to heat. That's why we're having the bath and burner there. So on heating, you're going to be able to get potassium manganate 7. You're going to get potassium manganate 6 plus manganese 4 oxide plus oxygen gas. So once you heat this potassium manganate 7, you get potassium manganate 6 plus manganese 4 oxide plus oxygen gas. Very important for you to be able to capture that. We can continue. The other reagent is sodium nitrate. When you eat sodium nitrate, you get sodium nitrate plus oxygen gas. Again, for a Form 1, we only interested with the word equation, but because this question is applicable for a student who is preparing for KCSE, we are not going to ask you to write a word equation. You are always going to be, for KCSE setup, you require to know how to write a chemical equation. Then we have the potassium chlorate, that's the formula for potassium chlorate. Once you hit this one, you're going to get potassium chloride plus oxygen gas. Very important for you to be able to capture that. So those are the ways, the three ways that when you hit potassium manganese 7, you get potassium manganese 6 plus manganese 4 plus oxygen gas. When you hit sodium nitrate, you get sodium nitrite plus oxygen gas. They're saying when you hit sodium, when you hit the sodium nitrate, you get sodium nitrite plus oxygen gas. Potassium chlorate to potassium chloride plus oxygen gas. Those are the possible equations that are required. And now we go to summary of preparation of oxygen gas in the laboratory. I want to show you a simple way how you can summarize the five methods of collection of oxygen. So you see, this one now, if you are using hydrogen peroxide here, you're going to use manganese 4 oxide here. If the liquid here is water, here you're going to use sodium peroxide to get oxygen gas. Then if you want to get, maybe you're using potassium permanganate, potassium nitrate or sodium nitrate or potassium chlorate, and you heat, you're also going to collect oxygen gas as shown there. And then the diagrams have shown hydrogen peroxide, manganese 4 oxide, you get water plus oxygen gas. That is now for the first equation. The other one is sodium peroxide plus water, you're getting sodium hydroxide plus oxygen gas. Look at this. The setup is the same. We are just varying the reagents. Hydrogen peroxide, manganese 4 oxide, water, sodium peroxide. And that's how you can be able to get the summary of the first setup. So the second setup is whereby now you are hitting now the potassium manganese 7, sodium nitrate, potassium chlorate. So you get potassium manganese 7 plus manganese 4 oxide plus oxygen gas. Sodium nitrate, you get sodium nitrite plus oxygen gas. Potassium chlorate, you get potassium chloride plus oxygen gas. Remember, you can also use both sodium or potassium nitrate can be used. So when you use potassium nitrate, you're going to get potassium nitrate plus oxygen gas, just like that. So you see, there are five methods of preparation of oxygen, but the setup can be summarized into two, the way I've shown in this particular summarized diagram. Very important. Two physical properties of oxygen gas, just a boiling point of negative 183 degrees Celsius. It is a colorless gas, it is odorless, and it is lightly soluble in water. Very important for you to be able to understand. So very important, those are the point. Two commercial uses of oxygen, it has to be an industrial use. Air enriched with oxygen is used in hospital by patients with breathing difficulties. Oxygen is used in the oxacetylene flame. We have the oxacetylene and oxhydrogen flame is used for welding and cutting metals. So you can be asked, name two other metals and other gases that are used together with hydrogen in welding. And we have ethylene, or rather acetylene and hydrogen, whereby which form now, ethylene or rather acetylene plus oxygen, you get oxyacetylene flame. When you mix oxygen and hydrogen, you get oxhydrogen flame. Both are very hot flames and are used for welding. Another use of oxygen, when mixed with helium, it is used in mountaineering and deep sea diving. Very important. Describe a test for oxygen. We don't tell students to state, but in many times the exam will ask you to describe. So make sure that in gases, you master the description. Describe a test. It should be such a a logical and precise description such that even if you give the same procedure to somebody who has never entered a chemistry class, he'll be able to carry out the test and confirm whether it is oxygen or not oxygen gas. So the test for oxygen, you lower a glowing hood explained into a gas jar suspect to contain oxygen gas. The glowing splint will rekindle in the presence of oxygen gas. So if you lower a glowing splint into a gas jar full of oxygen, it will relight. So if it relights, or rather it is rekindled, it is oxygen. If it is not, then it is not oxygen gas. Give a reason why it is not advisable to collect oxygen by either upward or downward delivery. The density of oxygen is very close to that of air. Very close to that of air. In fact, the mass of air is around 30. The mass of oxygen is 32. So any gas whose mass is between 28 to 32 has almost the same density as air and cannot be collected by either upward or downward delivery. So the suitable method for collecting such a gas is the use of a syringe. The use of a syringe is the best method that can be used to collect that. And for such questions, like you've seen, get a copy of the Chemistry Revision Guru, the Chemistry Top-Notch Revision Guru, which uses the octopus technique, as I've shown you. In my analysis today, I've navigated all the possible ways in which an exam can be set. So get a copy of the Top-Notch Revision Guru and you'll be able to get more of such questions. That is going to make your revision more interesting, more simple for you, and is going to give you the expectations of the examiner. Remember to subscribe and click on the notification bell so that you can be notified if I upload a new video.